Hi, and welcome to Off-Grid News, our take on the on-grid world. Today, why we oppose wind farms and solar farms. Politicians like to suck up to green voters by coming out in favour of wind farms. It allows them to keep in with the big energy producers at the same time. At offgrid.net, we like individual wind turbines and solar panels, but we oppose large arrays of them. We believe in distributed power, consumed at the place of production. Big wind farms attract big government subsidies, paid for out of our taxes. Spending large amounts of public money adds to politicians' sense of self-importance. But in the case of solar or wind farms, this money goes straight into the coffers of large companies, who could perfectly well afford to build power generation without subsidies if there was an economic case for it. Meanwhile, small-scale energy producers are disadvantaged, forced to pay over the market price for solar and wind energy if they want to receive the same subsidies, and subject to the same onerous planning restrictions. It would be more far-sighted to subsidise energy producers who did not sell their power into the grid, but instead created mini-grids, selling direct to neighbouring consumers. And we think big wind farms, along with solar farms and big hydroelectrical projects, are only marginally better for the environment than gas-powered or nuclear-powered generating stations. These projects have an overall negative environmental impact when all the downsides associated with them are considered. Not only are their benefits limited, but they waste good land. Wind farms and solar farms are slightly less polluting, but they still consume multiple resources and still lose between 30 and 50% of the electricity they generate in the process of transmitting it around the country or between countries. They still leave energy production in the hands of a tiny oligopoly of utility companies who spend more effort trading the energy between themselves than they do increasing efficiency and reducing costs to the consumer. The big eco-pressure groups like Greenpeace and Friends of the Earth also love wind farms and solar farms, but their position is tainted. They seem to have spent so long ingratiating themselves with big business and politicians that they've forgotten why they're here and become too like those they once opposed. They take huge donations from active and retired business people who say they want to make a difference, but not too much of a difference. That has been another issue of Off-Grid News. Thanks for watching and see you again soon.